I would like to announce Ganef presenting the FTP team and enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you everyone for showing up and welcome to this year's FTP Master Talk. My current plan, even if you can't read it on this beamer, projector, is to talk about the history of the FTP team, going back to when Debian started. After that, I will describe the roles of the team. We have three of them currently. I follow up with the current job we are having, and then I'm going to describe how you could help the team or join it if you want. So let's go to the history. We are starting with the scripts. It started with scripts that Ian Murdoch and Ian Jackson later on just wrote on the fly and got it somehow. At the time when Guy Maurer joins the team, he rewrote the whole stuff in Perl, and since then it's called deinstall, a term we still know, even if it's now just a shell script. The thing at that time wasn't exactly secure. You could upload it, and it got shipped. There was no GPG signature, nothing on it. The trust level at that time was, if you could upload, go on. When James Troop joined the team, he started a rewrite of this whole thing, going from Perl to Python, and that's still what we have currently, and it's known as Duck. The hosting of the machine, it started under a desk somewhere at Zemich.edu, and then got the first master Debian org, which was hosted by Bidel somewhere at HP. And the first machine, I'm sure you can't read it down there because it's too small. It was an HP, I even can't read it because it's small here too, yeah. It's an HP Vectra 486 with 66 megahertz and had some ISAS GASI controller and two disk drives with a size of 330 megabytes and 600 megabytes. And there was room to spare with the archive, which is pretty nice. It had two 5.25 full head drives in that. And when it got out of away from Bidel and into the first hosting, it got upgraded and had some 1.3 gigabyte drives in them, which had lots of room to spare at that point. And it was the first machine to host a .debian.org system on the net using Debian itself. The machine then moved to iConnect, and from there FTP Master got to Nuvare for a few years, then to VisiNet, where it was known as FTP Master Debian.org for the first time, got relocated to AboveNet, and then had a short break at the HP data center in Fort Collins, which is currently dissolved, and the machines that are still left there are going elsewhere. And current FTP Master machine sits at Brown.edu, and they are happy to continue the hosting of it, luckily. A bit history about the archive. The Bo release had only the Intel architecture. Hum had added M68K, which we later on dropped in Edge a few years. And we have a few more releases between them, continuously adding architectures, so that currently with Lenny we are up to 12 architectures. For Squeeze, we already added two new ones, those K3BSD ones. Let's see what we get later on. We currently have two proposed architectures, from which at least the AVR32 one looks pretty good to get included in one of the next releases. Let's see what happens to them. The archive size is also interesting, going up. Bus with some 230 megabyte size, slowly getting larger. The first gigabyte release was Bo with 1.2 gigabyte, and current Lenny, all architectures, requires already 125 gigabytes on the machines. And I want to see when we get the terabyte per release, Squeeze plus X. It's interesting to define how big X is. I guess it's not more than 2 or 3 already. The daily pushes, which is all the new packages and start going out to the mirrors. In the year 2005, when I joined the team, we had some 200 megabyte up to 2 gigabyte in an average 1 gigabyte pushes once a day. Currently, we are pushing between 1 and 6 gigabytes with an average of 2-4 times a day. So quite a lot of traffic on the mirrors. I've taken a week or something to write down a complete history of the team whenever someone joined. Oh, as usual, not readable from far about. We are started with Ian Murdoch, of course, somehow. And later, Ian Jackson, Bruce Perens, and Bede El-Gharbi joined the team. Back then, it wasn't clearly separated between the archive maintainers and the whole administration crew, so all of them just did whatever they could. We had Guy Major taking over the job and moving to his Perl D install somewhere in the years 95, 96. Unfortunately, no one could tell me yet when exactly he joined and started working. If some old-timer is hearing that, I do want those information because it's the only one I'm missing. We had James Troop and also Richard Brackmann joining in July 98, and they later got Antti Juhani, however you spell his name, Kajanaho, Ibit, and also Gergely Madares joining the team in 1990. Later on, we had Michael Beatty, Omnic, going in 2000, and work on Katie started also in the year 2000. Anthony Toynes joined January 2001. Months later, Guy Major became inactive, and then we had Ryan Murray joining in June 2001, the last FTP master to quit currently. Wendell Donner in November 2001 joined and was followed by Daniel Silverstone in the year 2003. And then we had a 2-year period of nothing until the team got restructured and the current assistance role got added. That was the time when I joined in March 2005. We had another period of nothing for 3 years until Kalle Kivima and Thomas Fiemann joined as assistants. None of those two is still in the team, unfortunately. We had myself getting up to FTP master in April 2008. Shortly after that, Anthony Towns and James Tru left, and the other current FTP master, Mark Reimers, came in as assistant in July 2008, followed by Frank Lichtenheld, DJ Pick, in December. Shortly after that, Thomas Fiemann resigned, unfortunately. He went out of complete Debian, not only FTP master. We added another assistant in January of this year, and a little later, Ryan Murray left the team about the time when we promoted Mark Reimers to FTP master, and Kalle Kivima recently, at the beginning of DebConf, left the team. The current team, as such, is made up of Mark Reimers and myself as FTP masters. We currently have 2 assistants, which is Frank Lichtenheld and Mike O'Connor, both of them unfortunately very busy. And we currently have 1 FTP trainee, which is a role I will explain a little later, Barry De Vriese. And since April 2008, we almost always had people in the FTP trainee role. So the current FTP master role, the easiest way to describe it is to quote a cited from Matthew Garrett, we are responsible for maintaining the infrastructure required to support the archive. This takes the form of the scripts used for processing uploaded packages, but also the flow of packages between distributions. As such, our job is to keep the archive running, keep it legal, and support the teams that depend on it, like the release teams, the security team, soon also the backports and volatile teams, because it gets integrated into FTP master now. And we have to keep the archive up to date with the requirements of the project, which is, for example, the source V3 stuff coming from Buxi, but also TDEPs and DDEPs, and I go to that later also. The FTP assistant role, created in the year 2005, adding myself and Jeroen van Wolfener at that time, that allows additions of people to the FTP team without having to give them the full FTP master rights. Those people in the FTP assistant role can process an EUQ, they can handle overrides, and they can remove packages, which is most of the day-to-day work, besides coding, and they can do all the common actions but can't do too much harm to the archive. So it's a good step between nothing and the full write set. And now the FTP 20 role. We created that in 2008 to make it even easier for people to join, because getting someone into the new queue who hasn't ever done any kind of work in that area isn't that nice to them and to the project. It was initially called Slave New, but somehow they didn't like the name. Can't imagine why. And we currently had 6 people trained so far. 2 of them promoted to assistants, and 1 of them got up to FTP master later. They can take a look at new, they can look at everything that is in there, and they can leave comments. The comments are then read by an FTP master or an assistant and acted on. Either they are right and we just do whatever they want, or we tell them what they missed out. The current archives we support is once the main archive with unstable experimental testing and all the stuff we have there. We also have the security archive since Woody, it's running with Doug. And the security team has multiple suites in there. We are currently going to integrate the volatile archive. It will stop being a separate service, but being just another suite on FTP master. And the backports archive, it's currently run by me, but we want to integrate it proper into FTP master, having a backports Debian org somewhere running. So let's describe the job a little bit more for removals and overrides. Removals are, one part of them are semi-automatic via Craft Report. That's a tool which is running in every deinstall run, sending us a mail about packages that we shouldn't have in Debian anymore, mostly because they are superseded, like library packages where a new upload is going in and the package is renamed. That gets in not built from source anymore for the old ones. There are packages in experimental where a newer version is in unstable and various other checks. And then there is manual, where we have a nice HTML page basically summarizing up all our removal bugs we have on FTP Debian org. Whatever the maintainers wish to remove, we get that in a nice list and can just copy and paste the comments over if we agree with the removal. Like if there is no reverse dependency left on a package, we shouldn't remove one that has a few hundred build dependencies or something. The other job with overrides is currently still the priority and section stuff, where sections is something that should go away. The override disparity mails people get whenever they upload a package and then find out that FTP master thought something different, that an application isn't in X11 anymore, but in UTils or something. They get a mail and can reply to us and ask us. That's currently by mail, but we want to have it in the BTS to make handling of that easier and also easier to follow what's up with them. New, the holy cow of Debian. The checking there is about 3 things in the order of priority, that is trying to keep the archive legal. We usually don't want stuff in the archive where there is a big fat header in there. If you distribute that anywhere, we are going to sue you. We had people uploading that, and we don't like that. It's also trying to keep the package namespace sane, which is hard with 20-something thousand packages. But we usually try that non-random maintainer goes and uploads some x-something or kde-something, which doesn't fit in there. And we are trying to reduce the number of bugs in Debian, but that's very low priority. We can't do full quality checks on new packages. That would make new queue 10 times the size of it. The most common checks we are doing is checking the whole source for license problems for new uploads and for license incompatibilities or non-free license terms, like I just mentioned one. We are trying to get packages that are splitted, having that in the same way. Like recently we had one package that tried to create 30 binary packages, each with one file and one symlink back for the user doc. We don't like that very much, especially as the dependencies didn't change. We try to keep policy violations out of the archive as far as possible. We have Lintian running for that whenever we are going into new. And also an important point is the source for everything included. Most of the licenses requires us to redistribute the source together with the binaries. Unfortunately, some of the upstreams just forget that. So the code we currently have, it's in a Git archive, it's Python, and a bit of Shell, and a bit of Perl, and honestly, also a bit of C. It's at least 9 years old. At least 9 years ago, we have the first commit message for it. And we have currently about 40, 42 different authors for the whole code base. So you can imagine that it looks different from file to file and it's not easy to maintain. So what you can do to join the team? Well, first you can try to join the QA team, our army running for old packages that are no longer of use in the archive, getting them out of the archive, trying to find out what needs to be done, like all the reverse dependency change to a newer package or something. And generally just do QA work. If a package doesn't become that unmaintained, that it needs to get out of the archive, it's something that will never get to us. You can just go on to our bug page and maintain the bugs if you want. Like many people just don't get it with the right format of the bug title for removal bug, so it never shows up on our removal list and might get lost, rename it, or close bugs that don't apply anymore because someone requested a package change and stuff and it was done years ago and we just missed the bug. And make sure that all the stuff on the bug page has some kind of sense. We never ever bite anyone who is modifying our bugs. Have fun with it, it's open, do it. You can only help. There, write code. This page intentionally left blank. Please write code so we can put it in here. Yes, you, I know. But I didn't want to put it in here, it was a bit too much. And then join the team. Mail us, ask us that you want to join the team. Usually we get people in here, unless they already have way too much roles. We have multiple people already with multiple roles in Debian, and we know it doesn't help much. But if you have a bit of free time, mail us and ask to join the team. Our current plans for the future, that are only a few points. Right now, we are replacing the database code in Duck with some based on SQL Alchemy. Currently, the database code is wherever we need database access, it's done with an SQL statement within the code and then using some old PG Python library to get that via the database. We are trying to get that a little bit more modern using objects and stuff. The source V3 stuff, hello Boxy, is on our to-do list to do. It mangles up with the database code changes because they are huge, like a 5,000 line patch currently, and we are stuck in there somehow. We also want to split out the long description of packages files and making English nothing else than another translation, which makes packages files a whole bit smaller to download, which could probably get us rid of the pdiff stuff. We don't like that. It's very flaky. And we want to integrate dept tags and in squeeze plus two or something, get rid of sections, maybe have four sections or stuff left, but all the rest out of it. And all in dept tags. We have the TDEPS proposal, Neil Williams did some time ago, and we had a meeting about it already. That's still waiting. We have DDEPS, which is currently running in some Google Summer of Code project and preparing the whole archive rebuild. From the reaction, I think you are that one, or not? Well, okay. We have some mails exchanged there already. We are currently writing the code to get lint in auto rejects. So even before you enter new and then just get it back again, you get a reject already right at the upload stage for a set of lint in tags, which should be carefully selected so it only applies to the most several tags you can have, which should never apply, but unfortunately do apply sometimes. For the build defaults, we want to have auto-signing done. Currently, all the build stuff gets mailed, the whole log to the build maintainer, and they have to sign it and do the work for all those. And with 1,000 packages uploads a day, we have 11 architectures, 11 build maintainers who all have to sign 1,000 build logs. And that just is tedious work, and we could make it better somehow. The proposal is already written down, and we are currently in a discussion between DSA, build maintainers, and FTP master getting it all done. It's pretty far already. And we want to throw the binaries away that maintainers upload. We still want to keep binary uploads and require them, pass them through Lintian, but then throw them all away and have them all built on Debian machines, on build Ds, which has a few things that we need to change. We need changes in the D package because we need a new control files dancer for that. For architecture, all packages, when we throw them away, not all of them can be built on one architecture. On all architectures, they can only be built on one of them, and we need to mark that somehow. It's also part of the multi-arch proposal, the same field, so that helps pretty much. So, also, thank you for sleeping through this talk. As usual, I'm pretty fast through those slides, so we can take the rest for questions and answers, if there are any.
I guess you can guess my question, sorry.
Yes, I can guess your questions. Your patches.
Well, can you give us a time frame?
Your patch is on our list, and it should be done within the next 2, maximum 3 months. We are nearly done with SQL Alchemy, and right after that is your patch.
Okay, because, well, the problem is time is going on, and it's quite a large transition. And
yes, we know.
We need to put it rather sooner than later, otherwise we will...
The thing is, we do want this patch later. Somehow in the archive, but we do not... I don't want to go against Mark's work. Your patch is changing database stuff. He is having a 5,000-line patch already, and if we mingle that up, it's pretty bad. But yeah. We are nearly done. It's only, I think, one file left, and then we are in the testing phase of that SQL Alchemy stuff, if it all works in the archive as expected. It should, but, well, let's test. And after that, your patch is coming in.
Okay. There are not many SQL queries in my part of the patch, so it shouldn't be too difficult to merge it, I guess. I can try it if you want.
Yes, Mark should have put it up somewhere. Contact me later and we can see where the Git tree is.
Okay.
Someone else? Yay, no questions. Everyone likes FTP team. Okay, let's make it something different. I want everyone... There is a question, yes, but until he has the microphone. I want everyone that has a bit of free time to join the FTP team. Please apply. We want more people. We want more people going through new. We want more people doing removals. Well, that's pretty much handled, but still, we want more people. Everyone, please apply. Steve?
Okay. Couple of questions. I'll do one first and then let other people dive in. No. Right. Couple of questions. I'll say I'll do one first. In terms of the current mess with Linux Modules Extra and friends, I mean, I know you already know about this. Has anybody looked into doing the extra coding work needed to replace it with something that works?
The current mess with what?
Linux Modules Extra.
I think Mark looked at it at some point and didn't have a very nice comment in IRC about it. Yes, we
well, okay. Well, Linux Modules Extra is the best example, but there's actually
yes,
quite a few other things using
the same
infrastructure.
Yes, we do have a general problem of other packages depending on the source of something else, which we currently can't handle in the database, so we might lose the source of it. We need a general solution for it, and it's somewhere on our to-do list. It's just a not-so-nice task.
Sure. I mean, as far as I know, Mark has ideas on how to do it.
We need database changes and stuff to link between, and yes... We already thought about it. We aren't yet there.
Okay.
But we dislike those packages and we want something better for them.
Sure.
It's a mess whenever we get to a release and need to have another suite within the archive which no one sees, but we have like Sarge R0, Edge R0, Lenny R0, which just have links of sources so they never get removed. It's
And of course it also breaks other people like Debian CD who have to do their own parsing of the archive.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's fun.
Isn't it possible to simply do binnmu right after just before the release so that the build really uses the latest sources that we're going to ship?
The problem with that is that you can break the package with it if you just binnmu it away. Okay. And right before the release you don't want to do that.
Okay, if nobody else has another question, then I'll dive in with my second one. I've been prodded by a couple of people specifically looking for more guidance over what will be accepted by the FTP team. I know that you're busy, Please, a little bit more feedback to people when they ask for help would be really nice.
Okay. Get more people in the team, then we have more people to answer.
Speaking of getting more people in the team, could you explain a bit more the process and the timeline for getting from nothing to FTP trainee to FTP assistant?
From nothing to FTP trainee, it's a mail to us, and we need to like you, because we need to work with you later on, which is usually a given task, except for a few people. I'm honest. I'm not polite. In the FTP trainee role, we had people for like 4 or 5 months and then leaving because they either had no time or, well, and we had people going from FTP 20 to FTP team within a week. The usual maximum we want to set for the FTP 20 role is 6 months. After that, we and you also should know if it's work you can and want to do and have time for it. And so after 6 months, you should probably get FTP team unless you are very dumb. And when you have FTP team, there is no hard timeline where we want to get you up to FTP master or not. For Mark, I think it was a year or something, and Thomas would also have been promoted after a year if he didn't resign a month before that. So a year is probably a good guideline after which one can look at it.
Do you have requirements for FTP master more than FTP assistant? I guess if you don't write that code, have you had a chance to be FTP master? It's unlikely, I guess.
Requirements, it's basically built up a link of trust between us, and we should know you, and we should not fight against each other in the team. And, well, looking at the work you are doing, and if you get lots of complaints about the work, then it's probably not going up to FTP master. But if we are just going together and working together nicely and having exchanges of code and stuff and all that, it's usually easy to go up. At least it was for Mark.
So first, thank you for all the work you are doing inside the FTP Masters team, because it's quite clear that a lot of this work is not really fun to do, but necessary. I know currently the new queue is at about 200 or 300 packages.
Around 200 a bit, yes.
Yeah, well, between, yeah. What do you think of Osso's way to help you with new queue? For example, I think Charles Plessis proposed
the
to
wiki
have
a idea is nothing we like.
Charles Plessis proposed to have a team that would do copyright reviews before you would get to review them. There's another idea that's been floating around that would be to have several DDs assign the package or hack the package before it is uploaded. So it would have more review, and then you see that they had more reviews, you could prioritize those compared to the others.
Okay, first of that, we had the idea of a wiki new where everyone could just go and do something, and if you have a threshold, that won't ever happen. The review team, feel free to do one. It's basically what Debian Mentors does to new people. You can do that with every other DD if you want to. You can just ask someone else, look at it, and see what I have done. We don't stop you from that. We won't open the new queue for that. For legal reasons, we can't do that. We can't open it for everyone. And a team of people looking through it and signing it, we have too many bad examples, even from usually seen as good DDs that just overlook files in that. And we would need to build up some list of people where we would trust and where we would not trust. It would come to that no matter what. And I don't want that. I don't want people to build up in various queues and various lists. That is a good one. We could trust him. That's a bad one. We could not trust him. I think it should be attached to the FTP team, and we should just have lots more people in that. I think 10, 15 or something people doing new would keep it down forever.
But the requirements that you have for people to join the FTP team are quite high. You require, I think, 10 hours of work per week.
We are currently saying 5 to 10 hours per week because that is currently the workload if you want to keep new down forever. If you're having more people, it's of course going down. So if you have 10 or 15 people, hey, we are all done with 1 hour a week, probably.
Deadlock.
It's some kind of deadlock. Join if you have 1 hour or 2 hours. get more people that have 1 hour and join us and do stuff.
This is a message that was relayed from IRC. There was the question popping up with respect to Debian copyright and listing all contributors.
It was claimed
that there was coming different messages from different FTP masters. So what is the current situation?
The situation is that you should list every copyright holder that you can find in the source where the license requires you to list them, which is not that easy to do. It's probably easier to just grab for the copyright holders. We usually don't reject if you just miss one. That's usually a prod or two or something of them. It's bad if you are missing someone where the license explicitly requires you to list them. But then it depends on what we know of the maintenance, the package. I usually send a wishlist bug or a prod, which is the mail sent out of the new queue directly, asking about a change to the package. I usually reject when we have multiples of them or when I have other issues with the package that needs to be changed. From my point of view, it's better to have everything listed. I know that's quite hard for large packages. Hello, KDE team, wherever you are. But it's a work you have to do once, and then it's done.
About the problem of getting several people to process news so they don't each have to contribute 5 to 10 hours, you could perhaps set up a pledge on PledgeBank. I promise to spend time processing the new queue, but only if 5 other people sign up.
Interesting idea, yes, we could do that.
Yes, it's a number of overheads lower than 5, it's 2 for
a. Let's take the time constraint out, but if you want to be a long-time member, you will have hours of work. But join us, even if you have just 1 hour. Help. We want help.
Still about the new queue, some uploads are more important than others. For example, there are packages that you just upload and there's no dependencies on work being based on this package, so you don't care if it takes 2 months. But some others are more important because you have to package something else and upload something else. So if it takes 2 months, it can be 2 months multiplied by 5 uploads. Is there a way to prod the FTP team about those uploads so that
do it like all the people do that have that problem, mail us.
Okay,
FTP master at Debian.org. Okay. We randomly have requests like coming from the DI team when they are uploading all the DI modules. Or lately we had someone who had uploaded library packages and something else depending on those packages, asking for the right order and if it could go through and whatever. Mail us.
Or maybe if you are within a team, try to motivate someone to join FTP master to process those packages first. Is that something? Is that a bad idea, in your opinion?
If the queue is down to a good level, which is something below 100, I think, we should try to process them all evenly and not go through. We already have some sortings in the new queue, like everything that only has new binary components and is not a complete new source gets sorted first. So my hope is that we have enough people that new queue isn't of interest anymore because it stays below 100 for the whole time. Anyone else?
So who wants to join the new queue new team? Only one, two, good. We can do the pledge right now. Maybe we will reach 5.
Okay, send mail to us. And everyone else, thank you for coming. Thank you for attending. Have fun at DevConf. See you later.